great. We forget to say the score for 1 minute, Paul, and they score 10 points. It's now 23-6.
Wow.
With 2 minutes left in the first quarter. Lakehead coming out on fire and just laying the smackdown on the Guelph Gryphons. Here's Malcolm with the ball. Greg Carter got cat. Kind of like from the southern United States, Paul.
Or PEI.
The PEI be like, Colt. Got Colt. Anyways, Greg Carter caught. The Ontario lingo, caught with his hand in the cookie jar there, called for the foul. Here's McCarthy inbounding for Guelph. Almost a steal there by Adam Johnson.
Everybody Johnson. Hungry out here for that cookies.
Adam Johnson reaching into that same cookie jar, same result. Mouse trap, snap. How do you like that? No good.
Wow, we want some love here. Let's get some love from the fans out here, man. Send us an email. What's the email address, Zach?
Thundercast@lakeheadu.ca. McCarthy pulls for three. No good. Tip no good. Malcolm with the rock.
Not Malcolm.
Oh, sorry. That's not Malcolm. Must be his brother. it's Campbell. Definitely not brothers.
No.
Campbell, rather.
JJ with the ball. Over to Greg Carter, who subbed back in. Inside of Johnson. Johnson, good move. Go straight up. Not able to get that roll.
Coming back the other way now is Angus up top to McCarthy. McCarthy misses the layup on the little alley-oop layup attempt. Lakehead's going to go the other way now. 23-6, 1:26 remaining in the first quarter. Coming at you on SSNCanada.ca, CILU Radio 102.7 on your FM dial here in the Thunder Bay and surrounding areas, and LURadio.ca. Greg Carter with the rock.
Yep. Over to JJ. Fenzel with the basketball, pulls up, feeling good. Not able to hit his third three-pointer. There'll be a foul on the ground. On McIntosh. McMahon, Anthony McMahon.
Mac Daddy. Adam Johnson appears to be a little shaken up. Speaking with Lakehead training staff, led, of course, by Joanna Sanchez. Joe's doing a great job. She's been here for a long time. She was here when we got here, Paul, and that was 6 years ago now.
Yeah, don't remind me, man. It's been a while.
So I don't think it would be a stretch to say that Joe has been an athletic trainer here for around 10 years, perhaps.
Perhaps
a decade.
She also went to school here as well. She's a Lakehead alumni, I believe.
Yes.
So.
Yes, of course.
For those, keep it in the family.
For those of you who may be noticing the absence of Yusri Salia, he is out with a lower body injury or upper body injury, mid body injury, as well as Brennan King, who is out with an upper body injury. Nice handoff there by Carter. Mac Daddy got fouled. He'll go to the line for two free throws, try to extend this lead.
Of course, these two guys played with each other in high school, St. Pat's, Ottawa, so they're very familiar with each other on the court. So.
And, of course, Lakehead alumni Matt Koslag, of course, head coach of the
St. Pat's
high school basketball team in Ottawa, who I believe today or last night qualified for OFSA going to city finals, I believe. Saw something on my Twitter feed or Facebook.
Twitter.
About that. One or the other.
Twitter.
Under a minute left now, 24-7. Lakehead blowing the doors right off his opening quarter. Ball over to the corner. Now it's Malcolm. Malcolm over to McCarthy. McCarthy. Handoff. Angus.
I want a burger right now.
Angus getting fouled on the hard drive.
Angus, don't give me a burger.
It's actually Zachary Angus.
That's a good name, isn't it?
It's a good name. Zachary, of course, my first name. Angus, actually, my father's middle name.
Wow.
So,
small world, Zach.
Small world.
It's a sign, Zach. It's a sign.
Small world. Angus knocks down the first. Since we're saying Angus here, we, of course, have to give a shout-out to Angus Young, whose guitar solo was bumping through the Thunderdome here during Thunderstruck. Angus Young, of course, with AC/DC.
I wouldn't know that, Zach.
Greatest rock and roll band of all time. If you disagree with me, let me know. Thundercast@lakeheadu.ca. We can debate about it.
I say Kiss. Zach, Greg Carter now inside of Thompson. Game clock winding down. 13 seconds left on the game clock. I mean, shot clock. Not 8 seconds left now. Wow, McIntosh with a tough shot there. Greg Carter brings up the layup. Wow. Just bodying his way in there to get that rebound.
Carter cleans up the mess, and here's the aforementioned Angus with the rock. 9 seconds left, driving hard against Joseph Jones. Puts it up over Mack, couldn't get it to go.
5 seconds left in the game clock. JJ has to put it up soon. Greg gets the ball, gets to put it up. Ooh! That would have counted if that went in there. So.
Good patience by the Lakehead Thunderwolves there, but they could not get the layup to go for Greg Carter. So that ends the first quarter, 26-9. Lakehead exploding out to a 17-point lead to start the game. I believe we have some shout-out here. Yes, of course, writing in the Thundercast feed, we have Wendy King, Brennan
Wendy.
King's mother, who I've actually met once.
Yeah, I also have met her once. Or a couple times.
Very nice young woman. And perhaps we'll be able to get King up here for an interview at some point, maybe halftime.
Possibility.
We're going to ask him how life on the sideline is treating him, something he's not as familiar with as myself.
Yeah.
Of course, Brennan King out due to an upper body injury. We will not specify. We will take a page of the NHL book and not specify the injury for fear of the opponent trying to target that injury. When the player returns the action.
Upper body.
But 26-9. Lakehead exploding in that first quarter.
Lakehead having a very good feeling right now. David Guetta's playing in the background,
yeah.
Zach. Yeah. Very good feeling. Got a good feeling.
Love this track. Gets me amped.
This is a big track, though. I'm not going
to
lie.
Listen to this track on the way to work this morning. Just got me excited about life.
Just winning.
Let's go to work. Ready to go to work. Well, there'll be no working for me, Paul, because this is, of course, a long weekend.
Yes, family day, of course.
3 days of straight.
Having fun. Just living
having
life.
Having fun and living life. In fact, tomorrow, I believe I will be going to Fort William Historical Park.
Wow.
Checking out the Voyageur Winter Carnival.
Wow.
For anyone out there in Thunder Bay looking for something to do on the long weekend. Very family-oriented event. I don't have a family. Plan on bringing my girlfriend. And, yeah, there's, like, snow
Zach,
mazes.
You do have a family, man. Where are your family? Come on, man. Don't say
all right,
that.
All right. You know what it is. You know what it is. We all family up here.
Okay. Calm down now. Calm down. Staying a little too far now. Second quarter about to begin here. Having fun here in the lightning rod.
Tons of fun. I mean,
my man, main man, Mr. Zach White Lightning. Of course, I'm here. Mr. Paul, don't call me Popo. Call me Popo. All right, let's go.
Here's McCarthy with the ball. McCarthy, a veteran on this team. I actually remember playing against him back in the day. Now we have Angus handling the rock. Angus taking a look over to Malcolm. Malcolm Young, of course, Angus Young's brother in ACDC, so this is actually a fantastic backcourt for the Guelph Gryphons. Here's Angus over to Malcolm. Knocks it down as the shot clock expired. Guelph trying to dig their way into this hole, and the ACDC combination getting it done. Malcolm Angus to Malcolm for the three.
Don't hurt yourself. Thompson, great pass there by McIntosh. Little high-low move there, and Thompson gets an easy layup. Score is now 28-12 for Lakehead.
Here's McCarthy over on the wing. Hard drive baseline to Campbell. Swings it to Malcolm. Here's McCarthy. McCarthy knifing through the defense. Can't get the layup to go.
Ooh.
Joseph Jones tough. Got shoved on the rebound. No call. Instead gets called for a travel. Tough play there. I mean, clearly Jones was pushed. He wouldn't just start walking around with the ball in his hand.
Well, that's how it goes sometimes. Wow, good move there by Guelph Gryphon. McIntosh got caught chasing.
We do with the bucket. Got caught Mac sleeping.
McIntosh now with the basketball on the high post. Ooh, good move there by Mac. Goes up with a left hand.
Got him.
That's the only way to make up for a bad defensive possession. Get Mac, right back on him.
Mac Daddy, get him out of there with a jab step.
Strong jab step there, Zach.
Yeah, there's a lesson to you young hoopsters out there. Don't need to put the ball in the deck to get somebody out of there. Good old jab step.
Ooh, Greg Carter, quick hands. Way to strip it, and then saves the ball from out of bounds. Over to Thompson. JJ now with the basketball. JJ nearly losing the ball. Greg Carter. Ooh, hesitation move. Goes inside. Offensive foul. Greg Getting a little too excited there. Yeah. Good move, though. I liked it. It looked good.
Good move. He beat the initial defender, but Weedu was just sitting in the paint waiting for him. And Greg got a little excited there, put it up, and called for the charge. But that's all right. He'll take a seat. And my main man, Nate Wainwright, will check in. All I got to say is the Guelph Gryphons had better find this man and get a hand up, because he is a knockdown, wet, shoot high. Grew up shooting the rock in the mean streets of Kappus Casing, Ontario.
Yep. It's dangerous out there.
Here's McCarthy. Guelph with the ball, trailing by 16 points. Blocking foul on Schmidt. Tough play there, as I thought he was in position. That's just a no-call. That's just good D. But Schmidt gets called for the foul. 8 minutes remaining in the first half, 30-14, Lakehead leads. Adam Johnson checks back in. Matthew Schmidt takes a seat with the second foul. Johnson was looked at by the trainers earlier, but he appears to be okay now, checking back in the game. Weedu with the rock. Looking to go to Angus. Nate Wainwright, big ACDC fan, guarding Angus. McCarthy over the wing, shots up. Campbell, no good.
Thompson over to JJ, over to Ben Johnson. Johnson to Johnson. Oh, Adam Johnson misses the first initial layup. Gets the rebound, puts it back in. Give a shout out to my main man, KO, and his little sister.
In the building. We got Angus. Zachary Angus with the rock. Skips it to the corner. Here's Malcolm. Another AC/DC connection.
Wow, Malcolm.
Angus to Malcolm. The AC/DC rock and roll train keeps on rolling.
Let's go.
Corner. 32-17 now. Guelph still trails. Lakehead with the ball.
Thompson over to JJ. Back to Johnson. Adam Johnson penetrating right. Nearly loses the ball. Shot clock winding down. Puts it up. Going to get bailed out there as he's going to go to the line and shoot. Shoot two.
Extra bailed out. Adam Johnson with nowhere to go. Nowhere to go at all, and he just put it up. Got fouled. Okay, chance to take a little breather here. The action has been hectic. Up and down both ends, scoring at a rapid pace, at least for the Lakehead Thunderwolves. 32-17, 7 minutes left in the first half. Adam Johnson knocks down the first. Adam Johnson doing a great job of late, as well as Matthew Schmidt, of stepping up in the absence of Salia and King, who, as we mentioned, are out. But Lakehead, such a deep team, very yep. talented, very deep team. Their 12th man can step up and score 10, 12 points for you any night.
Score now 34-17 for Lakehead.
Crossover. Here's Zachary Angus with the rock. Over to McCarthy. Back to Angus. Angus driving hard. Tried a little rondo. Angus out to Malcolm.
Wow.
Who knocks it down again.
That's three for three now.
The AC/DC rock and roll train keeps on going.
14-point game
as
now.
Angus kicks it out to Malcolm for the three-pointer. I feel like listening to some AC/DC right now on that headset.
I think Lakehead should put a hand up. That's what I think. Johnson. Ben Johnson. Going to get called. Ooh, blocking foul. Going to go in line to shoot two.
Tough call there. I thought it was a charge.
Yeah, that's twice you're wrong, Zach. So,
but we'll take it. All right, timeout here by the Lakehead Thunderwolves. Let us catch our breath here. 34-20. Lakehead was up by as much as 17. They now are up by 14 points. We got Evan E. Woodland, MC for tonight's game, filling in for Chris Brzezinski. I've been doing a good job, but, you know, there's just no replacing a legend like Brzezinski on the mic. Does an unbelievable job. Brzezinski actually did his radio interview this week on Rock 94. He was actually live on the air. I believe it was Wednesday morning or something, from 7:30 to 9:30. Got the chance to listen in on my way to work.
That's good.
Pretty funny guy.
Yeah?
Really, really rooting for him to get back with Rock 94. You know, he's a buddy of mine. That'd be cool. And I believe right now I'm seeing Franco Veruzzo
being generous right now.
Passing out popcorn in the stands.
Just like Robin Hood, just giving it away.
Did he maybe buy an entire tray of popcorn and just start passing it out to everyone? I'm not sure what's going on here.
You get him?
34-20 coming out of timeout. Coach Morrison can't have too much to be upset about. His team is only only up by 14 points right now. Make it 15 as Ben Johnson, a.k.a. Benji, a.k.a. the man of my dreams.
Wow. I didn't hear that one. He's up.
Knocks down the first one. See if he can knock down the second here. Ben knocks down the second. Ben, of course, rocks number 11, who was also rocked by another Lakehead legend, P. Precious. Ryan P. Precious.
Ryan.
Who perhaps is listening in. Adam Johnson.
Ooh,
what a steal.
Wow.
Up ahead.
Good pass ahead, too. JJ going strong. Lays it up.
Joseph Jones for two, making it 38-20. 6 minutes left. Angus.
Ooh.
Showing off the handles. Over the wing now. Thought about it. And then lets it fly. Campbell couldn't get it to go. He's over two.
Good rebound there by Johnson. Over to JJ. JJ Thompson nearly loses his footing. Able to get, gets the rebound. I love this guy's, like, the way he plays the game is just is good to watch. I mean, he's just so smart, understands the game, makes the right decisions.
Makes the right decisions even when
he's falling on
unexpectedly jump stops on a wet spot and starts falling down. He still finds the open man and reposts.
And gets a rebound. Pump fakes. Lays it up.
So composed. And we just got word that the Lakehead men's hockey team is up on the Guelph Gryphons 2-0. That's actually a playoff game, Paul.
Playoffs.
Yeah.
Playoffs.
Lakehead winning the playoff game on Wednesday, playing another playoff game tonight against Guelph. So that's pretty interesting. A little Guelph versus Guelph, men's basketball and men's hockey. Of course, men's hockey meaning a little more as it's playoff, and this is the end of the regular season. Lakehead already locked up first place.
Oh, Thompson hits both. Score is now 40-20. That's a 20-point ball game right now. We got a dub right now, Zach.
They're up a dub and they're doubling as they have doubled the score of the Guelph Gryphons, 40-20. Here's Angus. Angus handling the rock for the Guelph Gryphons. Over to McCarthy. McCarthy back to Angus. Angus knocked it down. Nate got caught on a flare screen. That's a very underutilized screen, I find. Very effective for getting an open three-point
it's
shot.
Hard,
flare
it's,
screen.
It's the passer that makes that play right there, because you got to recognize that your player is flaring. You got to make that pass. Johnson. Adam Johnson pulls up. Wow. Strong move there by Adam Johnson.
Adam Johnson, his confidence has gone up and has elevated his level of play along with it.
Yep, we all know, Zach, at his levels, 90% confidence. Ask my man Jeremy Lin, Zach.
Oh, yes. Adam Johnson with a steal down the court, streaking.
Ben Johnson swings it over to Nathan Wainwright. Thompson, Johnson asking for the basketball. Puts it up, misses the rebound. JJ crashing. Good hustle by Lakehead.
Yes, of course, Lin Sanity taking the NBA by storm. Yeah. The opportunity to see Jeremy Lin live in person last weekend in Minneapolis.
I must say,
actually,
that was an experience in itself, Zach. It's
myself, Paul, and a few other friends, including alumni Jamie Searle and Andrew Curion, went down to Minneapolis. It was a good time. Here's Angus with the rock. Down low, we got a foul on Adam Johnson. Once again, reaching into that cookie jar. He's got to just play straight up, make the guy make a move over you. No reason to reach in and give him a free one. Anthony McIntosh is going to check in. Back with Lin, I actually saw a hilarious photo today of it was a Photoshop photo of Lin taking a mask off, and it was actually Michael Jordan's face. And it said, gotcha. as if Jeremy Lin was really just Michael Jordan in disguise coming back, which would be hilarious.
As an Asian Harvard graduate.
Yes. As Angus, Zachary Angus, able to put it in. I hope I'm not offending Zach or any of his family and friends by announcing his name in a hilarious manner.
That's your name, though, Zach.
I just like that name. It happens to be my name.
McIntosh penetrating. Pulls up a dribble over to Thompson to Nathan. Nathan penetrating over to Ben Johnson. Johnson, tough shot. Hits it over two Guelph Gryphons as the shot clock was winding down. Wow.
Johnson knocked it down over three defenders. Tough shot. Looked like he might have got fouled on that one. And Lakehead continues to maintain that 20-point lead. They're up 45-25. So we got off to a quick start here. Now that we have a little break in the action, I'll paint a little playoff picture for you here, Paul. Lakehead, at 18-2, has locked up first place in OUA West, regardless of what goes on this weekend. However, they want to win these two games so they can maintain their number two overall ranking in the national rankings to, first of all, get a good seed if they get it to nationals, and secondly, in case they were to get upset in the playoffs, there is one wild card spot that goes to nationals. So if, knock on wood, anything were to not go as planned for the Thunderwolves and they had maintained their second seed, they would be a shoo-in for the wild card and get a chance to go to nationals even if they lost in the playoffs. So that's why that's Lakehead's motivation for these two games. Otherwise, they would probably just rest all their guys because they already locked up first place in OUA West. On the other hand, the Guelph Gryphons are sitting on a playoff bubble and need to take two games up here in Thunder Bay to make the playoffs. A lofty task indeed, as the Lakehead Thunderwolves, like I said, are first in the OUA West and second ranked in the country. And it's not looking very good for the Guelph Gryphons early on. If they lose tonight, their playoff hopes are done, and tomorrow night's game will simply be a chance to get a sweat on.
Chance to run around and play some basketball.
There's McCarthy. Over to Angus. Angus on the wing. Up top. Clark swings it. Malcolm with the ball. Malcolm off a pick and roll from Baring. Malcolm over to Clark. Clark to McCarthy. He pulls for three. Can't get it to go. Rebound's loose. Baring grabs the rebound. Baring, a 6'7 forward. Grabbed the rebound there. Clark swings to McCarthy. McCarthy puts it up. Second time's a charm for McCarthy from the same spot on the floor. Knocks it down on the second try.
We'll make a mistake twice there.
45-38. 3 minutes left here in the first half.
Ben Johnson over to Anthony McIntosh. Back to Ben Johnson. Penetrating. Picks up a dribble. Over to JJ. Shot clock winding down to eight. JJ pulls up for a three. Rims off. Oh, Thompson tips the ball over to McIntosh. Gets the basketball and lays it up.
Those buckets are just killers if you're trying to dig yourself out of a hole, Paul. You just can't afford those kind of mental errors.
Nope.
47-28 now, coming at you on SSNCanada.ca and CILU Radio 102.7 on your FM dial at LUradio.ca. There's the Guelph Gryphons being hosted by the Lakehead Thunderwolves here in the Thunderdome. Malcolm swings to Clark. Clark puts up the three, gets his own offensive rebound, puts up the layup. Clark finally on the scoreboard. 2 points to make it 47-30. Lakehead up by 17 points. 2 minutes left in the first half.
Good hustle there by Clark not to give up on a shot and get his own rebound. Ben Johnson getting a screen from McIntosh. Johnson still with the basketball over to JJ. JJ looking to go inside to McIntosh. Shot clock winding down again. McIntosh turnaround. No good. Will be a foul on the ground. On Lakehead. Ryan Thompson.
Tough foul on Thompson there. He was just fighting for the rebound.
Yeah, good hustle. I mean, that's what you want from your players. Crash. Eat glass, Zach. Eat glass.
Tough play. I'd like to take a chance now to give a shout-out to Brandon Makita, who's on the Lakehead bench with a chrome dome look. Now, we're not talking a buzz cut here. Brandon Makita has gone down to the wood, as the expression goes. It's a good look. It's a good look. Also, assistant coaches Andrew Creon, Nathan Johnson, rocking matching purple ties. Solid look. Solid look. There we are, 47-30. You can always get a hold of us at thundercast@lakeheadu.ca if you would like to give us a shout-out. We got a shout-out earlier from Wendy King, Brennan King's mom. Very wonderful woman.
Yep, shout-outs are free here, Zach.
Brennan King, such a gentleman. Such a fine young man. I mean, Wendy's done a great job over there in Petawawa just raising him.
Yep. Great guy, Brandon King.
Such a gentleman. You know, I bet if I went down there and I asked for it, he'd give me the shirt off his back.
He probably would. He gave me, I must say, true story. I left my charger back home when I went home for Christmas. had no charger in my BlackBerry for 2 days. Brandon Kim came through for me and gave me his charger. So, just a charger, but I mean, it's still something. I wouldn't have my phone.
Big,
so.
Man. You find out who your friends are.
When you lose your charger, yep.
As the country song goes, Paul. You can make a remix for that. Find out where your friends are when you lose your phone charger. Yep. Be a big one. Billboard. Okay, 47-30, Lakehead up 17. Here's Angus. Zachary Angus driving hard, baseline. Kicks it out, swings to the corner. Malcolm, he drives baseline.
Wow.
Nice up and under over McIntosh.
Tough layup there. Hung in the air, just floating. Look good. Ben Johnson. Looking to go inside. Picks up his dribble. Ball be tipped. Still remain like Lakehead basketball. Johnson can't just pick up his dribble like that and get himself caught in a bad position there. Nathan Wainwright inbounds to Ben Johnson. Penetrating. Oh, good pass inside to McIntosh. Ball be tipped off of Mac. No love for Wolfie, Zach. Wow. Wolfie just snubbed Zachary White in the booth right now.
It's tough to see in that suit. I doubt he saw me.
Snubbed ya.
With the rock. Guelph with the ball. 1 minute left in the half. Here's Zachary Angus. Over to McCarthy. McCarthy. Solid D by Wainwright, but McCarthy.
Wow.
Kept on going. Put it up and in.
Tough.
Franco still has that entire tray of popcorn. I don't know what the deal with that is. I'm going to go grab a bag at halftime, though.
Might as well. Shot clock down to 15. Game clock is at a minute. McIntosh, another jab step over to Thompson. Thompson puffcape. Goes up, misses. Oh, it'll be offensive foul as JJ went for the rebound. Good effort, man. Lakehead's crashing the boards. I mean, that's all you could ask for. Just got to be a little more careful. Now JJ trying to explain to the ref what he was trying to do. Ref, kind of look like Terry Porter is not having any of it right there. I'm not going to lie. It looks a little bit like Terry Porter. I don't care.
We do have some
I'm gonna say it.
Look-alike referees. Of course, Dominique not in the building tonight, but has rocked Thunderdome before. Paul, I was going to kick out of the area to the far bottom right of the gym where the little children are playing. Those kids just do not care about the game
at all. They don't give...
Like, they're just loving life, just bouncing around on the mat over there. Could care less, there's a basketball game going on.
They're in their own world, Zach. It's nice. It's good to be young, Zach.
I mean, they got no bills.
No care in the world. No rent.
They're paying no taxes.
Nope. You have to go to work.
They just want to get their pudding and their applesauce.
And watch some cartoons. That's all.
You know what I'm saying? Okay, a couple notes here from my main man, Matt Wainwright. Not feeling me hating on the Chrome Dome look as he sports that look himself. Not as much by choice, but by necessity. I'm well on my way there, so I can't say much.
He was also mentioning that
the band for Lumberjack, which is the legendary festival in Kappa's Casing every summer, the band is going to be announced on Monday. Apparently it's going to be huge. Last year was Loverboy. I don't know how you can get any bigger than that, but apparently it's going to be big. And if Nate Wainwright scores 20 points in tonight's game, the organizer of the event said he would tell Nate early who is going to be hosting Lumberjack. So I can't wait 3 days. I want Nate to score 20 so I can find out who's playing at Lumberjack.
Wow. Thanks for that little excerpt there, Zach. Ben Johnson now inside to McIntosh. Swing over to the aforementioned Nate Wainwright with a nice pass inside of Ryan Thompson.
Wainwright with a nice pass inside to Thompson, but that's not the right play.
He may get 20 assists, though, Zach. Does that count?
It does not count. He's got to shoot the rock if we want to find out who's playing at Lumberjack. 20 seconds now left in the half. Lakehead up 49-36. He's bearing, trying to body up on McIntosh. Mac with a good D. Lakehead in transition now.
Mac having none of it. JJ going hard. Thompson thought about it. Nathan Wainwright. Oh.
5 seconds left. Lakehead's got to make something happen. Here's Benji.
Oh.
Couldn't get it to go. And that ends the first half. 49-36. Lakehead up by 13 points. They led by 17 after the first quarter. Guelph was able to close that gap by 4 points. Leading scorers right now, we got Ryan Thompson with 10. We will see you in the second half, ladies and gentlemen. got King up here for an interview. Shit.
Brendan.
Should go get him. I don't know if he'll think that's cool. He probably won't do it. He'll probably scare coach and snap on him. Which is stupid, because what's he going to do?
I know. Look at you standing there.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back for the second half of this game, third quarter. Craig Carter over to Ben Johnson. Johnson with a pull-up. Tough move there. Wow. I like that move.
Benji getting it done early here. Here's McCarthy with the ball for Guelph.
Ben and Jerry.
McCarthy on the wing. Now it's Zachary Angus. Back to Clark. Clark tries to pull up, looking inside. Gets inside the bearing. Bearing bodying up on Schmidt. Can't get it to go. Schmidt with the rebound.
Good D there by Matthew Schmidt. Just staying his ground. Greg Carter is going to go to the rim. Yep. Called it already. Bucket for Greg Carter. See the look in his eye. I know that look.
Greg Carter, good job using his left hand to finish there. Makes it 53-36. Nice split in the D there by Angus. Finds Clark in the corner.
Wow.
Bricks another one. Clark having a rough night tonight.
Yep, rough. Venzel going to the cup. Oh. Good pass there by Venzel. So Thompson lays it up.
Here's Zachary Angus with the rock over to Malcolm. Malcolm driving hard. Tough turnaround jumper. Couldn't get it to go.
Takes some tough turnarounds. Unnecessary there. Craig Carter with good defense, too. Craig over to Thompson. Thompson. Buckets.
Ryan letting the flow grow. Thompson knocking down a three. Giving 13 on the night. 58 points for Lakehead, 36 for Guelph. There's Zachary Angus handling the rock. Over to Baring on the wing. A little bit out of his range, so gives it back to Angus. Angus to McCarthy. McCarthy looking to get to Baring on the blocks. Baring. Bodying up on Schmidt again. Puts it up with the left hand. Can't get it to go. Good post defense by Schmidt on back-to-back possessions.
Yep, great job there by Matthew Schmidt. Venzel penetrating, going to the cup. Lays it up. So smooth with that layup.
Not fun to have Venzel Russell coming at you in transition, let me tell you.
Nope.
Zachary Angus coming off the pick and roll. Angus over the wing to Clark. Clark handling the rock. Pulls up. Knocks it down. Making me eat my words.
Wow.
Deep possession. I said he's having a rough night. Just pulls it up in someone's eye there. Knocks it down. That's confidence right there.
Yeah, Ryan Thompson's eye. Still a score of 60-39. Lakehead. Inside to Ben. Ryan Thompson comes right back on Angus. Your boy Zachary got it.
Thompson feeling nice right now. 62-39. Here's Angus. Looking inside. Over to Clark. He's open again. Couldn't make it back-to-back. There's McCarthy getting the rebound for Guelph. Nice feed inside to Malcolm. He puts it up and in.
Good layup there by Malcolm.
62-41. Coming at you on SSNCanada.ca. CLU Radio 102.7 on your FM dial. Lakehead with the ball.
Ben Johnson penetrating. Ooh, a lot of contact there. Going line to shoot, too.
Ben Johnson put a little bit of extra acting on that one as Clark bumped him a little bit on the baseline. And yep. Ben flying about 10 feet. I think Clark would have to muster all the strength he had to move Ben 3 inches, let alone 3 feet, like he did on that play.
I think he's majoring in drama, Zach.
The fine arts.
Fine arts.
You're the thespian, Paul. Knocks down the first. Ben Johnson, a.k.a. Benji, on the line. Strong connection to Morrell, Prince Edward Island. Knocks them both down. 64-41. Lakehead up big here on SSNCanada.ca. New player checking in now for the first time. That's number 10, Mason for Guelph, checked in. Here's McCarthy with the ball. Mason checking into the game and getting down and dirty early. Call for the illegal screen. Excuse me, that foul was on Weirdo. Not Mason. Mason was keeping his dirty work clean. You know what I mean.
If you don't know, now you know, Zach. What? A great man once said that. Ben Johnson with the basketball. Penetrating over to the other Johnson, Adam Johnson. High low inside to Thompson with a nice pass to Greg Carter. Lays it up. Wow, that was nice.
Nice finish by Greg at the rim. Thought he was going to get up and throw that one down for a second.
Not quite sure about that one. No.
Here's Zachary Angus. Coming off the pick and roll. Good hedge there by Adam Johnson. Ball gets swung to the corner. Here's Mason.
Wow, Mason checking in the game.
Knocks it down. Comes off the bench, knocks it down. His second possession.
Wow.
Bang, bang.
Must be a shooter, Zach. That's all you do.
That's
yes, Mr. Q
down.
In the building.
Super fan, Roger Currion in the building. Walking by.
You should get on the mic, Mr. Q. You should get on the mic.
Franco Asinjo not pleased with that call by the referees, letting them know about it. Ball was ruled to be last touched by the Lakehead. Guelph will inbound. Here's Mason. Feeling pretty good. Just knocked down a three a moment ago.
Yep.
Dribbling up, being washed by Thompson. Mason's got a speed advantage on Thompson here. Here's Malcolm with the ball. Malcolm to Zachary Angus. Zachary Angus with a nice move. Gets his man in the air and knocks it down.
I like that one. Zachary. Showing off his repertoire there.
Zachary Angus, his shoes look like runners. I don't think they are, but I think they're ball shoes. But it looks like he's got runners on.
Some New Balance? Adam Johnson's trying to get the ball over to Ryan Thompson. Inadvertent pass there. Not a good pass. Turnover. Guelph ball.
I think he was trying to throw the ball in the crowd there as a souvenir, perhaps. Because that pass was nowhere near Lakehead.
I think Carolyn Fogali was calling for it from the women's team. He might have tried to get to her.
There's Zachary Angus handling the rock once again. Skip past to Mason. Mason driving right. Now he's looking to go inside. Mason. Got to make something happen here.
Wow, Weirdo.
Nice move by Weirdo. Weirdo knocked it down. Nice move by the big man.
Venzel, Russell penetrating. Oh, stripped there by Angus, I believe. Angus all over the court.
Good play by Angus. Now he's getting it back. He's getting double teamed, but he gets ahead to Weirdo. And here's Mason. Back to Angus. Angus doing it all for the Guelph Gryphons on both ends right now. I like Angus' game, man. He's all about the fakes. He dribbles it off his foot that time, though, and goes out of bounds. Not the most athletic, but he's a smart player. He's a crafty player, and he'll pump fakes a lot.
That's what you got to do, Zach. I mean, let the ball do the work for you.
Yeah. It's in the eyes, too. The pump fake is in the eyes.
It is. Ben Johnson, screened by Matthew Schmidt. Kicks out. Back to Schmidt. Oh, trying to get the ball to Johnson. Tipped. Guelph ball.
Here's Malcolm with the rock for Guelph. 66-48. Lakehead up by 18. Here's Mason from the same spot. Not able to knock it down on the second try. Good board there by Adam Johnson.
Johnson over to JJ. Benzel Russell now with the basketball. Penetrating. Ooh, behind the back. Post up now by. Good move there. Benzel Russell kicks it off glass there.
There is no one on the Guelph Gryphons roster that can guard Benzel Russell, nope. And that is just a fact.
Wow.
Missed layup there by Campbell. Lakehead the other way. 68-48. Lakehead up by 20 points. 3 minutes left in the third quarter.
Ben Johnson penetrating. Stops. Looking to go over to Adam Johnson. Shot clock going downside to Schmitty. Schmitty tries to dribble. Loses the ball.
Here's Campbell. Nice handoff to McCarthy. McCarthy puts it in. Lakehead not getting back there. 4-on-1 for the Guelph Gryphons, and they're able to convert for 2 points, make it 68-50.
And it's an 18-point ball game here, Zach. Adam Johnson with the basketball. Oh, turns it over again. Guelph ball.
Campbell, a nice move in transition. Couldn't get the layup to go. And now we got a Lakehead foul on Joseph Jones on the rebound. It's Joseph Jones' second foul. Adam Johnson, Ben Johnson, taking a seat. Johnson and Johnson combo checks out. In comes Greg Carter and Ryan Thompson.
Just want to give a quick shout out to my boy from Brock. Of course, a Brock Badger. My boy Brian Nahimina. I always have a tough time with his last name, but that's my boy from London, Ontario. Shout out to listen to the game. Back to the action, Zach.
There comes Venzel Russell. Russell in transition where he's so dangerous, he gets fouled. I believe Brock, did they make the playoffs? They're on the bubble, I think.
I should ask them.
I feel like I should really know the
you should know.
Playoff pitcher.
You should, man. Don't be asking me that.
All I know is we get a first-round bye, so I don't really care who plays in the first round. That's why I'm not as concerned with it. However, in the second round, we will be having somebody come up here. It could be the Brock Badgers, I think.
Could be.
Denzel Russell misses a second, but then gets his rebound, puts it in.
Misses a second, but Thompson tipped it.
Wow.
Here's Zachary Angus driving hard on the OUA Defensive Player of the Year, but he couldn't get it to go.
Matthew Schmidt hits that. Wow, good pass there by Greg Carter.
Matthew Schmidt knocks down the three and awakens the slumbering beast that is the Lakehead University home crowd. Crowd getting excited. It's Thunder Bay's finest. Matthew Schmidt knocked down that three. Here's Guelph on offense.
Wow.
McCarthy with a pass to nowhere. Ball goes out of bounds to the children's section where the kids are playing. They gladly throw the ball back into play. And one little girl pushes her little brother to the ground.
I don't think that's part of the action, Zach.
Hilarity ensues.
Lakehead controls the ball. A minute and 40 seconds left in the third quarter.
74-50. Lakehead now up by 24 points. Just blowing the doors off this one.
Grant Carter penetrating. Too easy for him. Going left. Nobody there to help out. It's going to be a tough day for the defender there.
Carter going to go to the line for two free throws. 74-50, 1.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Zach White, Lightning, and Paul Popola coming at you live from the Lightning Rod here in the Thunder Dome, Thunder Bay, Ontario, Canada, Lakehead University campus on sscanada.ca, CLU Radio 102.7 on your FM dial, and LURadio.ca. You can reach us anytime at thundercast@lakeheadu.ca. We'd love to hear from you. Another missed free throw for the Thunderwolves. This time not so lucky as Guelph got the defensive
wow.
rebound, rather, but then turned it over.
Venzel's cookie jar going hard to the cup. Euro step. Tough to defend that move there, Zach.
So tough. I mean, as a defender, you're setting up. You don't want to foul the guy. You want to beat him to the spot. So then you go to the spot, but he takes a Euro step and goes to the other spot, and then you look like a fool. Very tough play to defend.
Yeah, he's mastered that. You know, he's done that a few times on the playground, Zach.
Lakehead, cold from the free throw line, misses another one. I think that's the third of their last five free throws they've missed. Finally, Denzel Russell will knock that one down. Now with the ball, Campbell. Campbell handling the rock. Being watched by Denzel Russell. Campbell over the wing. Up top. Who the hell is this guy? Thompson? Campbell with the rock. Hand off to Thompson. Thompson, the southpaw, put it up, got fouled by Schmidty. He'll go over the line for three free throws. Bad foul by Schmidt there as Thompson, cold off the bench, just checked in. Had to do a pull-up three, fading away. That shot had very little chance of going in, and Matthew Schmidt fouled him, giving him three shots, which are much more likely to go in. And as I say that, he misses the first one. So somebody putting a cap on the rim for these free throws on both ends, as neither team can knock it down from the charity stripe.
Wow.
0 for 2 for Thompson. Thompson, freshman from Oakville, Ontario. It's actually kind of funny because, and Thompson misses all three, and he hears it from Heckler's Row.
Fans out. Russell coming full speed over to JJ. JJ, nothing but net. Lakehead makes you pay for your mistakes.
Tough sequence there for the Guelph Gryphons. Missed three free throws and give up a three on the other end.
Not a good exchange, Zach.
We actually have Thompson guarding Thompson now.
Both from Oakville.
Both from Oakville.
They may be related, Zach.
There you go. Perhaps they are. Tough shot there as the shot clock expired. Guelph getting nothing on offense. Lakehead getting whatever they want.
Wow, Venzel Russell is showing some dribbling skills there. Dribbling clinic. Looking like a Harlem Globetrotter as the shot clock is winding down. The game clock as well. 6 seconds left. Venzel penetrating. Oh, over to Greg Carter. Good pass. Greg not able to grab that.
So we got 3.5 seconds left. Lakehead up by 29 points. Guelph with the ball in their backcourt. Goes into Zachary Angus. He's going to put up a desperation pull. Wouldn't have counted if it went. So three quarters of play, 79-50. Lakehead 1 point shy of a 30-point lead. You know, I got to say, Paul, it kind of, no disrespect to the Guelph Gryphons. It warms my heart to see Lakehead laying the smackdown on the Guelph Gryphons right now, simply because they used to be such a rival of ours.
They've broken our hearts a few times.
Oh, if you remember a few years ago here in this very Thunderdome, Paul, I believe it was our second year, last game of the regular season between us and Guelph. The winner made the playoffs. The loser started the Guelph season early.
Yes.
Came down to the buzzer. Questionable foul. No call at the end. Missed shot by Kieran Posey. Guelph wins, goes to the playoff. We lose, that was it. I think it was like 3 years in a row we played Guelph at the end of the regular season to decide who went to the playoffs, and all 3 years we lost. And I just used to have a great rivalry with Guelph. I disliked them then. So nowadays, times have changed.
Tables have turned, Zach. Tables have turned.
Tables have turned. Once again, Guelph playing in the last game of the season to try and make the playoffs. But this time, Lakehead laying a smackdown. So nice to see. No offense to the Guelph fans listening in, as there are, of course, a large contingent of our audience. No offense, but Guelph has broken Lakehead's heart on a few occasions in this building. It's nice to see we get some retribution.
Revenge is better served cold, Zach.
Yes. Yes.
As they say.
Although it's a little too cold because we're no longer part of it. So it's like,
I know, we're not.
It's really cold. Like, it's like yesterday's leftovers. It's not as good. It's like cold, like I got here now.
Depends what you had, though. Spaghetti sometimes is better the next day. I don't know.
Which begs the question, maybe you should just cook the spaghetti, put it in the freezer for a while, and then microwave it the first time. That tastes better off the get-go.
That's a little too much work there, Zach. Just eat it and then wait for the next day to eat the rest.
We're starting the fourth quarter here. Lakehead with a 29-point lead. There's Malcolm. Handling the rock for Guelph. Malcolm over the wing to Zachary Angus. Zachary Angus playing well tonight. A valiant warrior in the face of a brutal defeat.
It must be the name, Zach.
It's got to be the name. Nice step-through move, but he couldn't get it to go. Ryan Thompson coughs up the rock. Here's Campbell from the free throw line. He can't knock it down. He gets his offensive rebound. Puts it over now. Zachary Angus driving baseline. Met by Ryan Thompson. Good feed inside. We got a foul on Benji. As Benny was trying to put it up. Benny, 6'7 forward from Waterloo, Ontario. Waterloo, of course, is going to be hosting this year's OUA Final Four.
Oh.
Just 2 weekends from now, Paul.
Of course, you have some Lakehead alumni that reside in that lovely city of Waterloo. Right,
yes,
and precious.
And surrounding areas. I'm sure Lakehead will be well represented if we are fortunate enough to make it to that event. We must win the playoff game next weekend in order to qualify to go to Waterloo for the Final Four.
Score now 79-52 for Lakehead. Greg Carter with the basketball. Hands off to Ben Johnson. Johnson penetrating. Back to Greg Carter. Over to JJ. JJ with a three. No good. Not this time.
Nice box out there by Benny. Here's Guelph coming the other way. Handoff. Ooh, McCarthy. Wow. With a nice forearm
shiver there.
McCarthy looking like a running back, just getting that forearm out there. Stiff arming kids.
Wow, man.
Got caught that time. Frustration, starting to show a little bit for the Guelph Gryphons.
At least they're not giving up, Zach. I mean.
Oh, they're going to keep fighting, Paul.
They're going
to
fight.
There's a lot of basketball left to be played
Greg
here.
Greg Carter. Wow, got up high. Too high there as he missed the layup.
A little too much English on that one. Couldn't get it to go. Nice crossover there by Campbell. Handoff. Here's Malcolm with the rock. Malcolm back to Campbell. Campbell.
Wow, in the eye of Greg Carter.
Campbell, they make some delicious soup. Knocking it down.
Chicken noodle, my favorite.
That's very, very delicious.
Yes.
Campbell, it'll knock that one down.
Greg. Campbell all over Greg. Greg's like, give me. Greg didn't phase him. Penetrates, but lost the ball.
Put up a tough shot, couldn't get it to go.
Yep.
McCarthy over to Malcolm. Malcolm, nice little floater in the lane, got it to go.
That's a good move there. High percentage shot there, a little floater. I like that move, Zach. Score is 79-57 for Lakehead. JJ with the basketball over to Greg Carter. Ben Johnson pulls up. Short jumper. No good. Thompson battling. Gonna get called for out of bounds on Lakehead. Good effort there by Ryan Thompson. Just going hard, Zach. Must be the hair.
We go hard.
He's like
today.
we should call Thompson. I'm gonna call him Samson. I think it's his power from his hair, Zach.
Yes. Samson. Same syllables, similar sound. Getting it done. Samson. Playing defense right now on Clark.
Yes.
Here's a nice move from Benny. Bodying up on Schmidt. Schmidt once again playing solid post D. Smitty. JJ Jones with a turnover. Oh. Malcolm with the rock now.
Wow.
With a nice scoop on top of JJ Jones.
Malcolm could go toe-to-toe with layups with Venzel Russell. They could battle. They could do play horse or layup horse. That would be exciting.
Malcolm, fourth-year guard from Brampton, Ontario. So the Guelph Gryphons have some good pieces in Zachary Angus and as well as Malcolm.
I mean, I would like to see Malcolm. I mean, he's taking a little. I like the way he's playing. He's trying to get his teammate involved. But I would like to see him be a little bit more aggressive and try to make something more things happen. Like, he's letting the game come to him, which is good, but probably need a little bit more right now. So, I mean, he was hitting shots from the three-point line earlier. He was 3-for-3 earlier in the first half. I haven't seen him taking a shot in the perimeter since then. So, I mean, not going to hurt to start shooting now, Zach. I'll tell you that.
No, I mean, they went on a nice little run there. 9-0 run. They now only trail by 20 points instead of 29. So that's a step in the right direction, certainly. Franco Veruzzo handing out the last of his tray of popcorn. I'm going to have to ask him later what was up with that.
I know, eh?
Feeling generous. Bought a whole tray and started passing it out, I guess.
Must be the last regular season game, man. I mean,
second last, of course, tomorrow night.
Oh, yeah.
Tomorrow night we will be doing it all again. Deja vu, Groundhog Day, whatever you want to say. Lakehead
basketball. Okay.
Up in T-Bay.
Listen, man, you just got the freestyles today, eh?
I'm feeling it.
T-Bay Bay.
We might need to lay some beats down.
Should I give you a beat right now?
Maybe we'll save it for after the game in the parking lot, you know, lay some beats down. Get a little freestyle going.
We could battle after. Thompson now.
Samson.
Good move.
Up.
Samson, yes. Gets his own rebound. Samson with the layup. Screaming. Give a little warrior chant right there, Samson.
I love the Samson war cry. I mean, it rarely comes up, but when it does, I mean, he's such a quiet guy, Samson. When he brings out the war cry, it just gets me very excited.
Yes. You know it means business when he brings it out.
Tough up there by Zachary Angus. Joseph Jones all over him. Zachary Angus not going to lay down and die. He's going to keep on fighting. Angus, second year, Basher in Commerce and Marketing from Burlington.
Weak. Only know the real men do finance, Zach.
Yeah.
I'm just joking.
I'm not a businessman.
I'm a businessman.
There you go.
So let me handle my business.
Bring it out. Yeah. I'm not an engineer. I'm a...
I don't know where you're going
to go. Engineer.
Don't do it, Zach. Don't do it to him like that, man.
Engineers don't get shout-outs in rap songs for some reason. I don't know. Like, businessmen get more love.
Yes.
I don't know what's up with that.
I wonder why, because businessmen run the world, Zach. That's the only reason why. Ben Johnson with the ball. Inside to Matthew Schmidt. Good move by Schmitty. Pull up. Count it.
Schmidt's confidence with his increased minutes and his good games the last few weeks, he's flourished.
Zach, we've said it once. I'll say it again. At this level, it's 90% mental, man. And once you get that confidence going, you can play with anybody.
Is that... Are my eyes deceiving me? Did Venzel Russell just take a charge? No, it was a block.
No, he didn't.
Block.
No,
okay.
He didn't.
For a second, I was wondering what went on there. Might have been Venzel Russell's first charge. First charge drawn, that is. I'm sure he's given out a few.
All right. Yep.
Not exactly a defensive stopper.
I mean, he does get out of steals, Zach. So... He's one of the top steals in the OUA, I believe. So, I mean,
yes,
that's still defense.
And definitely at the top of acrobatic layup.
Yeah.
That was a statistic.
I think he's number one. Aforementioned Venzel Russell with the basketball. Inside of Thompson. Samson. Samson with the layup. No wall cry this time, but good layup. 85-63 for Lakehead.
Samson. Down the rock. Here's Clark. Clark, turnover. Lakehead, the other way.
JJ calling the play here. Over to Samson. Deep three. Downtown. That was downtown.
Oakville.
Arthur Street? I'm good. Oh, yeah. That was from the corner of Arthur Ford right there.
Knocking it down. Right, JJ Jones was calling shirt a designed play for Lakehead Thunderwolves. Ryan Thompson was trailing the play. Showed it to Joseph Jones. JJ, screw the play. Throw me the ball. I'm feeling hot. And then launched a three from 4 feet behind the three-point line and knocked it down.
When Samson calls for the ball, you give Samson the ball. Okay?
And he knocks
down a
three from the freaking badminton line.
JJ, good move. Pump fakes. Strong move there. Big fan of the jump stop.
Yeah. Very effective. Very effective. The defender just keeps moving and you stop.
Yep.
He's gone. You put it up and in. Good move by JJ.
I mean, playing the point guard position, I wasn't very big, so I mean, I had to use that to my advantage there, Zach.
Lakehead up 90-63. Lakehead could break the century mark tonight on offense, which would be a first for this season.
Samson with the rebound.
He got hit.
He didn't even phase him. He didn't even know he was hit, Zach. Oh, look who's coming in, Zach.
J.R. Alexander checking in. Freshman from Winnipeg.
Getting some burn here, Zach. Some PT.
He's going to get some solid minutes here. There's 4 minutes, 44 seconds remaining. He can try and elevate this team to 100 points.
Yes, Zach. If I was him, I would put on my Rambo clip right now. I mean, it's a good opportunity. Put it on. Start shooting.
Why not? No reason not to. Lakehead's up big here late in the game. You're getting some burn. Go get yours, JR.
Yeah, Venzel. Great pass there by Matthew Schmidt. Recognize the cut from Venzel Russell.
Nate Wainwright going to get a little extra burn here. Campbell, nice crossover drive. Put it up and in.
Penn Johnson. Calling the shots here over to Thompson. Schmidt open for the jumper. Oh, not able to hit. Venzel Russell going up there for the rebound. Off Venzel. Griffin basketball.
Nate Wainwright checking in. Venzel Russell takes a seat. Hears it from the crowd. Russell with a big night tonight. 22 points, but the leading scorer in tonight's game is Ryan Thompson with 29.
Wow.
Feeling good tonight. Guelph with the ball. Lakehead up 92-65. Here's a good drive here by number 31 for Guelph. Fantastic number, if I do say myself. Jack Betty. First year guard knocked it down. Make it 92-67.
Guelph now going to a 3-2 zone here, I believe.
2-3.
Thompson with the ball. Oh, great pass inside to Schmidt. Schmidt not able to hit.
Guelph deciding to switch it up here with 3 minutes left. There's Betty trying to put a move on Wainwright.
Wow.
Betty handling the rock over the wing. Morris inside. Nice jumper there. Square up, knocked down by Benny. And, Paul, it is actually Subway night. Each fan will receive a free 6-inch sub because the Lakehead Thunderwolves scored more than 85 points. That's fantastic news.
Fantastic. Schmitty. And one. Good move there by Matt Schmidt. Of course.
Matt Schmidt keeps adding to the total. I'm going to get some of these Subway coupons.
All right, give me one. Sagway going to chase down the Subway coupons. Loves his food. They're trying to
I'll split the 6-inch with you guys tomorrow.
Look at the expiry date, man.
Apparently they're still good.
I went to Subway and they turned me down.
It's a Lakehead organization is passing out void Subway coupons. Warden had better dust.
You better fix this problem right now.
Pull his socks up, if you will, and fix that problem.
Yeah, I went to Subway. They turned me down. They said, this is expired. I'm like,
what?
I looked at the date. I'm like, yes, you're right. It is expired.
Wow.
I couldn't say much.
Wow. Unacceptable. However, back to the action here. 95-71. Lakehead up huge. Wainwright with a turnover. Nope. Lakehead recovers. Adam Johnson. No good.
Oh.
McIntosh. This could be bad.
Nope. He's good.
That is the absolute last thing you would want to see in a game like this with Lakehead up huge. 95-71. Don't want to see any injuries. You already have two of your starting, your number one and number two bigs. Excuse me, on the bench. In street clothes. So 2 minutes left, 95-71. Lakehead up huge here on SSNCanada.ca. CLU Radio 102.7 on our FM dial. Guelph throws the ball out of bounds. Lakehead's going to go the other way. And there's only 2 minutes remaining. Paul, I think this is a long foregone conclusion, but I'm going to go ahead and take out the pierogies and Persians. Anyhow.
Yep. You might as well.
You know,
I think I already started eating them. I'm down to my last Persian.
No, I actually literally had a Persian before I came here. I had some sushi and then a Persian.
That's a weird combination there.
Like kind of an Oriental feel and then a Thunder Bay feel for dessert, you know, with the Persian on top. It's kind of a weird vibe, but it's good overall meal.
All ends up in the same place, I say.
95-71. Doesn't look like Lakehead's going to get to the century mark, unfortunately. Not that that really matters at all.
Still a lot of time left. Still a minute 30 here left. I mean,
it'd be cool to see those, those light bulbs over the third digit get a little bit of love. You know, they're rarely turned on. They're just dying to light up and be bright. That's what they're designed to do. But that number one in front of the two digits just never gets lit up. So it'd be nice to see it get lit up tonight.
Yes.
Get a little bit of love.
Still a minute 20 seconds left in this game. Ben Johnson calling the play. Only 5 points to the century mark, Zach. Nathan's going to help us here. Ben Johnson wide open. Yup. Zach, you talk a little too soon, I think. We've got a minute left in the game. You tell me you can't get 2 points, Zach?
I don't know. Lakehead may not. Really, they only have one, maybe two possessions left. Ooh, three knocked down there by Betty.
I'm guaranteeing a century mark right here, Zach.
Guaranteeing.
If we don't get a century mark, anybody...
If they don't score here, they're not going to.
Listen.
If they don't score, they're not going to.
You could chirp me all day, Zach.
Well, buckle your seatbelts, ladies and gentlemen. One possession to get 100 points. Here it is. JR with the pull-up.
JR, did he do it? He did
it! There it is!
I guarantee it.
There it is!
I told you.
The crowd erupts as the number one lights up 100 points for the Lakehead Thunderwolves. They're now up 24 points, 100-76. Guelph with a basket. On the one hand, Lakehead had a fantastic offensive game. On the other hand, they gave up 80 points to a team that's not even going to make the OUA West playoffs.
This is true.
That's a poor defensive night, but a fantastic offensive night. They put up 100 points. Shot clock winding down. JR with the rock. He's going to try and get a season high here. Adam Johnson, no good.
This is going to be it, Zach.
And that's it. 100-78. Lakehead Thunderwolves win. They reach the century mark. Free section subs for all.
See you tomorrow.
We'll see you tomorrow, same time, same place on SSN Canada or our CIOU Radio 102.7. These two teams will face off once again for the final regular season game here in the Thunderdome. 8 o'clock Eastern tomorrow night. Women's game at 6 o'clock. We'll see you tomorrow.